Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Can I just take a quick poll as to how many of you have experienced credit ratings with your ventures? Okay. I specifically asked experienced because what the experience was. Was it good, bad, or satisfactory? Yeah?
Satisfactory and learning.
Satisfactory and learning. How many for satisfactory and learning?
One,
two, and how many had bad experiences from ratings? Okay, so the others, neutral? Well, I have been coming across quite a lot of comments and also people who have been sharing their experiences that the reason why credit rating is coming in their way in getting better loans or the interest rates are increasing, the ratings probably are not giving what we need. So it has become really a hurdle in many cases in getting finance. Why is that so? Now, look at what was the earlier scenario of lending. Most of the earlier lendings happened based on the past track record or the security value. The data analysis was done of the past financial statements. Not so very transparent as far as the SMEs are concerned, but still it used to give an whatever analysis was done was giving an insight of what happened, not much futuristic in nature. And the decision, because it was sitting in silos in some branches, some credit officers doing it, it was often cited as arbitrary. Many times it was felt that the person who understood the business, by the time he understood it, he got transferred. And the next gentleman, he comes to understand the business, it is taking some time. So now, the credit rating, which has now come in, tries to build in this credit judgment of human judgment along with measurement of risk by understanding or parameterizing risks under different categories. Now these categories are given some numbers and then they are added up to give some sort of an objective analysis to the subjective risks. The main aim is that not only the past is an indicator of what is happening, what has happened, but also what is likely to happen in future. So when you have some numbers to support the decision, it becomes much more transparent. Now, before I go ahead on this, just a symbol which is coming, whether it is from the bank's own internal rating model or whether it is an external rating model, it is just not a thing saying that it's likely to default or it is not likely to default. It is on a scale. So if the rating is very good, meaning the chance of default is very, very low. But if it is on an average, yes, there may be some probability of default. Whereas it is poor on a scale of say 1 to 8, it means that the default chances are very, very high. Given this, now let's say when we are looking at from an objective point of view, what as a rating agency or a lender is likely to look at? When a common scale is used, the scale of operations, if a business is not growing, if it is continuing to show the same level of profits or operations, it would not get a good rating. It has to show growth. The earlier speakers have also mentioned about it. The management and governance becomes very, very important. So that's not, again, having a fancy board, but honoring commitments. That's one important thing when it comes to the management of governance. And how the financials look like, and what is the industry outlook. Now, this pie chart may look very, very simplistic, saying that okay, 50% is for financial industry and outlook, and some additional information which is being collected, which are non-financial with related to business. So non-financial parameters become very, very important whenever a lender is assessing a business. And so is the case with the rating agency. When a rating agency is looking, particularly in small and medium enterprises, the emphasis is very high on the non-financial parameters. Some of them are like time in business, succession planning, customer retention. If the customer is satisfied, if it has stayed with the business for long, meaning that yes, the business has been doing something good. Ability to pass on the risk to the customer, competitive advantages, weaknesses. And of course, the financial parameter is also there. Coming back again, one of the important aspects is the growth in the sales numbers and the profitability. And for SMEs, what becomes more important is the cash flows. And how cash flows are derived, and cash flows, if the way they are presented, often get influenced by changes in accounting policies. So if changes in accounting policies have happened in the past and that has impacted the operating cash flows, so that is something which would definitely affect the credit rating. So when I talk about governance, what the fiscal discipline or the governance basically means all these things. When a business, first and foremost, it has to understand its own risks of doing business. A lender will come later, an investor will come later, but if I'm doing my business, I need to know what are the risks associated with this and how am I preparing myself to take care of the risk. Whether the market is, if there is an excess capacity getting built up, and that excess capacity would lead to pressures on the price. Now, how do I keep myself? I cannot dictate the price which the market will dictate. My competitors would be asking for a price. I'll have to match it, or else I'll be out of business. So the other way probably would be for me to cut down on cost, reduce the flag, so that even at that price, I will still be making profits. I have a client whose turnover actually came down from 200 crores to 120 crores and finally to 60 crores. Why? Because in his industry in 2007-2008, there was a huge capacity addition. And the competitors started selling at much lower price, which was not sustainable. And this particular client, he has been able to maintain the same quality. So he did not cut on the quality issues. As a result, today he is still surviving with lesser sales, with continuing to make profits, whereas others who cut down on cost, provided lower quality, are out of business. There have, in the same industry, there are three other companies who have shut down shop. Now, when the shakeout happens, one with a lot of integrity and the business model which is right, would likely to remain in the business for a longer duration. How the business objectives are aligned and what the structure, the company, whether a business, if it is small, every decision making being centrally focused, a sole proprietorship concern is good enough. With the company bill which is likely to be passed, even the possibility of forming a one-person company would be there and it would be very much acceptable. But if the scale of operations are increasing, you have to add people with functional responsibilities, maybe partnership, much better, an LLP. Going forward, a private company. And if IPOs have been thought about, again going forward as a public limited company. But not necessary to have a public limited company from the very first day, because the organization structure may not support that kind of legal structure for the company, for the business. If the business has developed know-how, intelligence in terms of doing the business, how is it protecting itself? What are the steps it is taking? Is it still continuing to innovate and add on to the complete basket of services or products that it is offering without stretching again too far, in the sense that it may affect its sustainability? Most important is the market ethics, the marketing ethics. And so when lenders, CS lenders would like to, or even investors would like to take feedback also from the customers, that okay, how the services or the products have been, as far as this business is concerned. One point which I have added over here is the financial governance. What I mean by financial governance is leveraging, excessive leveraging in terms of uncertainty, in times of uncertainty, is very, very risky. So to avoid that, the fungibility of money going from business to personal and personal to business has to be avoided. Money which is required for the business has to be kept in the business for the uncertain times. So the rating, basically, when it finally comes down to once a unit level performance has been assessed by a lender or a rating agency, one does the peer comparison across companies similar size in the same similar industry. What is the outlook of that particular industry? For example, I mentioned that there was an excess capacity which had got created in a particular industry. If that is the case, that industry per se itself will get a low rating. And then how that industry performs against the other industries. So all put together would be the final rating as far as that particular entity or business is concerned. Lastly, I would like to mention that wherever we are not happy with the rating, it is important to know the rights also. That as far as the internal ratings of the banks are concerned, most of the banks, almost all the banks, have adhered to the bank's commitment to MSCI's code. They have adopted it, wherein they have agreed to disclose the internal ratings to the SME clients and also disclose the methodology, and that would be adopted in arriving at the rating. Banks have been advised, and even as per the code, the interest rate terms have to be linked with the rating which is assigned. As far as external credit rating agencies are concerned, SEBI has issued guidelines that core areas should not be outsourced. Core area relating to the rating should not be outsourced. It should be performed in-house by their own people, by the rating agencies. So if a rating agency approaches you, you are very much within your right to understand that what would be the procedure which would be adopted by the rating agency, what would be the steps which would be involved, and if need be, you can get a sign-off. It is usually mentioned in the terms and the agreement which is signed. If not, you could ask for an exchange of an email or a letter before you give the assignment. And finally, any company or any business which has got itself rated has the right, if it is not happy with the rating, not to disclose, not to accept the rating, and the rating is not disclosed.